I appreciate that you are representing the brand for the interview. How much NWA do you have at home?
Enough to wear a new shirt every day of the week, and probably enough sweatshirts to look like that I wear a new one every day.
That is definitely impressive. A big show coming up, Hard Times. Excited, I have to assume, to be part of that show.
Oh, yeah, super excited.
Yeah. Tell us more, the people besides myself. What are you doing as part of Hard Times?
So on Saturday night, I'm going to be challenging Davey Richards for his MLW National Openweight Championship on the pay-per-view. Right. I'm super excited for that.
Now, I'm excited to see that in action because your career has been very exciting for me to follow. I was at some of those Ring of Honor shows where you were the young boy and like, oh, who is this guy? You're a grizzled old veteran at this point. What are you, 25? And you have like more experience than everyone?
26, actually. 26. 26. I've been wrestling for 13 years. So half my life at this point has been inside a wrestling ring.
Yeah, you have been going around the world, young boy, young lion, properly on television now. Did you know that you were going to get to this level when you first started?
I never expected to get this level, but I always hoped that I would get here one day. And it feels like it really does feel like a dream come true, being able to do wrestling as a full-time job and be able to provide for my family with wrestling. That's literally all I've ever wanted. Like when I was a kid, my dream wasn't to main event WrestleMania or get signed to WWE. It was just to be able to make a living through professional wrestling. And I'm doing that right now. So couldn't be happier.
Yeah, that reminds me of the punk rock DIY indie approach to things where you know that not every band is playing arenas and theaters. Some bands are playing the VFW halls, the matinee shows and all that, but they're earning a living. And then over time, that band, that independent band becomes a rightful headliner on their own end, kind of like you.
100%. Like I'm super big into the music scene and I'm big into like pop punk and a lot of emo bands that if you don't listen to those genres, you probably wouldn't know a lot of the bands that did. But when I go to these shows, even though they're not mainstream per se, and they're not people, the shows that the general public would like, I go to these shows and there's 1,000, 2,000 people there. There's 500 people there. Like, and that's how it feels like independent wrestling is to me. I'm not just wrestling in front of 10 to 20 people every time. Like we have giant crowds and it might not be as big as WWE crowds or AEW crowds, but there's just to be able to make your living from a performance art. It's a very cathartic experience.
My words, not yours. Some of those crowds are as big as the SmackDown crowds and the AEW dark crowds. You look at the hard cam shots of some of that stuff. So you're selling yourself a little short there about some of the crowd sizes that you are wrestling in front of.
Oh yeah, like don't get me wrong. I think the biggest crowd that I've ever wrestled in front of was 5,000 people at one point. That is not a number to shake a stick at. That's a very large amount of people in any sport or any event. It's awesome.
So something I mentioned earlier was the first time that I saw you, I think was Hammerstein Ballroom show in New York, and we didn't know what was true and what was not true. And it was kind of the most brilliant storyline, he's the young boy, he's the trainee, he's the whipping boy of this whole thing. I'm sure there's elements of truth to that, but you portrayed that so convincingly that it was tough to know what was real, what wasn't real.
Oh, 100%. Like the young boy thing, it was kind of a rib on me. And it was a rib on Adam Page before me, like, both of us were required to carry that bucket around through the airports every time we traveled. And I don't know if you've ever seen the dimensions of that famous water bucket we've carried up close, but that does not fit in any luggage. It doesn't, like, you have to just walk around with a bucket when you're walking through the airport. It is it definitely felt like a rib at the time, but looking back, it is hilarious.
When you're the victim of, for lack of a better term, hazing like that, does that make you, when you get a certain point or age, want to do that or go as far away as humanly possible from doing that to other people?
I don't want to make it sound like it's a blanket term because I feel like my hazing was a lot like it. I wasn't I wasn't getting beat down, or I wasn't getting like humiliated or abused or nothing. But I definitely think it taught me a bit of humility. So I don't want to tell people that it's okay to go out there and harass the people, the new people, and wrestling or the frat houses or whatever. But I think that a little bit of it goes a long way to teaching respect for wrestling.
Well said. So hearkening back to stuff, hard times is coming up, big match is coming up, and we see you evolve into somebody that we no longer think, hey, that's Steve's kid. We think, hey, that is Colby, a star in his own right. And NWA is a great ground where it's a mix of legends, the next big thing, people on the cusp, all that kind of stuff. Is that your favorite part of NWA, or what is it if not?
100% the locker room and who I'm able to interact and work with is my favorite part of the National Wrestling Alliance. It's a joy to be able to go to work on these weekends and be able to work with my coworkers. There's so much talent that I'm able to be able to take advice from it and get and have opportunities to listen to things that I wouldn't be able to. There's not many other shows I'm going to be on Trevor Murdoch or The Pope with, or Chris Masters. Like, there's so much knowledge that's right there that, like, is it for someone like me who just loves professional wrestling and loves learning about professional wrestling. Like, it's just like, it's like a cornucopia of just knowledge right there. And that's my favorite part of it.
And do you know any bookings that you have with NWA after Hard Times, or is that after that, we'll see what happens?
Oh no, I'm definitely with the NWA after Hard Times. I don't think they've announced dates yet, so I don't want to put stuff out there, but this ain't my last appearance with the NWA by far.
That is fantastic to hear. Life outside of the NWA, is there a interesting side hustle? Is there a side business or anything like that that we should know about?
Actually, no. I'm 100% a full-time professional wrestler. And don't get me wrong, I do some other stuff like in the realm of professional wrestling. I'm a professional wrestling trainer too. I train at a school here in North Carolina, do that about 2 or 3 days a week, depending on my schedule. I make merch, my own merch, like t-shirts and stuff. I have a t-shirt press in my garage, so I manufacture all that stuff. My wife is a wonderful designer and artist, so she does a lot of like art and gear designs for me. So even though like I'm not at wrestling shows during the week, I am always working on something wrestling related, or I'm doing media stuff like this one right here. Like, so,
well, where I was going with that is when you speak with a lot of wrestlers, when you ask that kind of thing, you don't know if you're going to get the answer of, oh yeah, I've got a sports bar, you should come to it. Oh, I've got my microbrew line. Like when you talk to somebody like Gallows, the number of businesses that guy has.
I can only imagine. He knows how to work.
Yeah. So long term, is just the full-time wrestling where you hope to be, or will we see you acting and doing other things in the entertainment realm?
Don't get me wrong. Like I love professional wrestling and I always want to be a part of it, but, I would love to expand my horizons too, but I don't think I'll ever leave wrestling. I don't think I'm ever going to turn into The Rock to where, I take off from wrestling for Hollywood. But I might be a Miz where I'm shooting the Marine 4 and 5 or something on the side, you know?
Yeah. The news of, MJF in that Von Erich film, I think, change things a little bit in the business where you never know who's going to be acting while an active competitor.
100%. I'm real close with Luke Hawks, who does a lot of movie stuff.
Skills, and yeah, he's great.
Yeah. I'm actually helping one of the actors in the Von Erich movie. I think he's playing Flair. I'm helping him do some research in North Carolina so he can like kind of get the vibe of what live wrestling feels like. So that's pretty cool as well.
That is fantastic to hear that movie has so many professionals attached to it, keeping it legitimate, because it's going to be better than Body Slam, the movie, and all the 80s movies we used to get from wrestling. But back to you here. Two quick questions, and then you're a free man. The first one, we talked about music at top. What's the last concert you went to for fun?
The last concert I went to see was the Wonder Years. They performed Suburbia and... what's the other album? The Upsides as like a two-part concert, and those are two of my favorite, they're my two favorite albums by them. So me and my wife went to see them. And while we're talking about live shows, the shirt you're wearing, it was actually my first concert ever. I went to see Cheap Trick, Poison, and Def Leppard. Was my first concert ever when I was 12 years old.
Wow.
I'm a big music guy. I've seen so many shows.
Did you go see that band, that show, or were you a Poison, Cheap Trick, Def Leppard kid from young?
I mean, like, I liked Surrender by Cheap Trick, but I was most of Poison guy, and my mom was a really like Def Leppard. So I was like, all right, I'll check it out. So definitely enjoyed it.
That is great to hear. So it sounds like you have the same musical influences as Mr. William Patrick Corgan.
Yeah, I guess you could say so. It's always so wild to me that like my boss is an actual rock star that like, and that transcends the wrestling world. Like like when my wife talks to her friends about it, she's they're like, oh yeah, we love the Smash Brothers. She's like, oh yeah, my husband works for Billy Corgan.
Lightning one. And the last question I got for you before you go, do you have a TV recommendation besides watching NWA on YouTube and the like that you could pass along?
Like a non-wrestling TV?
Yeah.
Ooh, man. So I don't watch a ton of TV. I usually end up just watching a lot of documentaries and stuff. Big fan of Breaking Bad. I just rewatched that. Big fan of The Wire. I'm a big video game guy too. I just got God of War Ragnarok today, and that's currently on pause as we're doing this. So,
well, we're not going to keep you from there, but I think we're learning here. You have the same exact taste as most of the people watching NWA every week.
Yeah, I guess I guess you could say that I also am a wrestling fan, and I like wrestling too. There seems to be a lot of common denominators. I like a lot of the nerdy fandoms. Big anime and video games and whatever. I'm all about it.
There you go. Well, I'm hoping that you become a champion. Well, yet again, because you've held a lot of belts, but a champion again at hard times. Looking forward to whatever's to come from you in the near future, Colby. Thank you for your time.
Thank you for having me. Paltrocast.